perfect. So we're going to use a strap today, a towel, a sweatshirt, anything that you can hold in your hands. And then just for comfort, if you have any blankets or couch pillows around, those are always nice because it just gives us a softer surface for later on and for the end of class or something to sit on when we're doing some of the stretches. So take your time, just make sure that you have plenty of space to move around, and we'll go ahead and get started. We're gonna start standing today. Take your time and come on up. And we'll take the strap, set it down. We'll come back to everything in a moment. And just take your hands to your hips and then roll those hips in one direction. Some nice deep breaths. Good. And we'll go the other way. Good. Now step one foot forward, one foot back. And we're just going to gently tilt towards the side away from the front leg. So gently opening the side here. Take a breath or two. Perfect. Come back to center and switch sides so the opposite leg is forward and move away from that front leg. Good. And just breathe here. Nice. Come back to center. Shake out your hands. And we're going to roll the wrists one way and the other. So just some simple circles here. And now keep this nice circular movement. And now take your fingers right to the tops of the shoulders and just go one arm at a time. And we're just seeing how we feel. And we're not going to feel even on both sides. We already know that. So just feel how it is for today. Any tightness, anything that's resisting. And we'll add both elbows whenever you're ready. Just rolling down, inhaling up, exhaling down. Nice and smooth here. And a few more. Nice. Now let your arms relax. Take one ear to your shoulder and breathe in. And as you breathe out, draw that chin down towards your chest. All the way to the other side and inhale and exhale, chin down towards your chest. Perfect. Just do that one more time on each side. Nice. So let's come to our mats and just kind of facing forward, feet are about hip distance apart. Reaching the arms out and up, give yourself a little belly stretch. And now bend your knees, come down. Just hang out for a moment, see how this feels. Just to hang here, relaxing your head. Now taking the hands down, coming onto the knees. Good, so the wrists are under the shoulders and the knees are under your hips. Start by wagging that tail side to side as if you had a long tail and you're just moving it side to side. This feels really good in kind of the glutes, the outer hip area. Nice and smooth here. Perfect. Now we'll take our knees a little wider and sit back to child's pose. You can bend your elbows as much as you'd like. Forehead down and breathe. And this is a place that you can come to anytime, whenever you feel like you need a little bit of a break, or you just want some rest or to stretch your back. Child's pose is always available. Good. Walk your hands off of your mat a little bit, go to one side, and just let your hips settle down to the other side. Switch sides, let your hands go the opposite way, breathe in and breathe out, let your hips settle down. Good. Come back to center, we'll find all fours again. those wrists under shoulders, those knees under hips. Perfect. And now we'll move into cat-cow. So exhale, round your back, drop your head down. And then as you breathe in, you're going to let that belly fall. You'll feel that mild stretch in the belly, maybe that scar area. That's totally normal. Should feel kind of like a stretchy sensation. And then exhale, round your spine, drop your head. Nice and easy. Inhale, arching, just looking forward. And breathe out, round your spine. Do two more breaths like that. Nice and smooth. Perfect. Okay, so taking our hands forward about a step. Tuck the toes under and we'll come into downward dog. And if that's not possible, just come into child's pose. We'll lift our hips nice and high and press the hips back towards the wall behind you. And now just walk those feet forward so that you're in a nice forward fold. And we're going to interlock opposite elbows here. So your arms are just hanging and the head is hanging. And let yourself sway side to side so that head is loose. That neck is loose. Now walk your hands up your shins and up your thighs. Come all the way to stand. Good. And then give yourself those circles here one way. We like to keep that low back nice and loose. And the other way. Very good. We'll do some lunging here. If we take the feet hip distance apart, keep your right foot forward, take your hands to your hips and step your left foot back. Beautiful. So that right knee is over the ankle. And you're pushing through your back foot. And breathing in and out. And now we're going to change our arms. We'll start by taking the fingers right to the shoulders, like we did in the warm-up. If that's okay, maybe make 90 degrees here so your palms are facing the same direction as your face. And then just take a few more breaths here, straightening the leg or strengthening the legs, feeling strong through the front leg and the back leg. Inhale here. And as we exhale, take your hands to your heart and step back up. Good. And then do those little circles again just to keep everything nice and loose. Perfect. Wonderful. We'll do the other side. Same thing. Nice and simple. Left foot forward, right foot back, hands to hips for balance. And feel the strength in your legs, front leg, back leg. And breathe. Now taking the fingertips to the shoulders, if you like that modification, or taking the hands out to the sides, palms face away from you. Kind of like cactus arms and breathe here. Inhaling, and as you exhale, hands to your heart, bend both knees a little so you can safely step forward and just circle those hips again, nice and smooth, keep it loose. Very good. Wonderful. We're going to stretch our hamstrings and our hip flexors a little bit today. So if you have a blanket and you're on a harder floor, I suggest cushioning underneath your knee. And if you're on carpet, you probably don't need to, but always know it's an option. So I'm just going to put a blanket halfway down the mat. And so that's there when we come into that low lunge. Good. Breathe in, reach your arms out and up, and then slowly come down. Just relax your head here. Now coming onto your knees, and if you're using a blanket, those knees go right on the blanket. And then once again, just wag that tail side to side. Stay nice and loose through the hips. Very good. We'll come up to the knees. And if you want a wall or you have something beside you for balance, you're welcome to use that. And we just bring that right foot forward so that we're in a low lunge. Very good. So that right heel needs to be down, but you can walk the front foot forward a little bit. Maybe interlace your hands and take your hands to the top thigh and just feel your hips settle. There you go. So I like to come in and out of it a few times, like up and down, so you feel this back hip flexor. Just make sure that right heel, that front heel is down. And then when you feel space where you feel like, okay, I feel that nice stretch, that scar area, kind of through the upper thigh, then breathe there. Wonderful. Come back a little bit so that you have a little more stability. Your knee is over your ankle. And now take your left hand to the outside of your right thigh. Push your hand into your thigh and your thigh into your hand. And then take your right hand to your sacrum and give yourself a little twist. Chin is away from chest. Perfect. Just breathe here. It should feel good in your upper back. Take another big breath in. Wonderful. Now unwind, move back to center, bringing those hands down. So we come back onto all fours and just rock side to side. Wonderful. So we'll get into the inner thigh and the hamstring a little more. So finding that right leg, the same leg we just used for the lunge, bring that right leg directly out to the side so you have your hip, your knee and your foot all in one long line. Good. And you can stay up on your hands or you can come lower to your forearms. You start to feel that inner thigh of that extended leg and just relax your head here and breathe. Stretching, opening that inner thigh. Your hands come up slowly. Now keep your hands down and we're just going to lift the right toes to the sky and bring them back down. So you see that movement? It's just a simple lifting of the foot and down, and we feel the back of the leg. If it's too much stretch, bring the foot closer to you and bend your knee. Totally fine. Do a few more of those. Toes to the sky, toes to the ground. Breathe through it. One more. Wonderful. Now just bring your knee in. Maybe rock and feel the difference on the right side and the left side. Knees come wide. Let's take a little break in child's pose. Relax your arms and your head. Slowly come up and we'll do everything on the other side. So now we come up to the knees and the left foot comes forward. Use a balance, use a wall if you need to or a chair. Left foot is forward, heel stays down, and we interlace the hands and take the hands right to that thigh and just dip those hips down a few times. You start to feel that back hip flexor. Good. You can really bring that left foot forward more so that you get this nice angle here. As long as the heel's down, it's totally safe for your knee. And just breathe. Good. Once you find that spot where you feel that back hip flexor, that scar area start to stretch, keep lifting through your chest. One more big breath in, and now exhale, come up slowly. Walk your foot back a little so that your knee is right over the ankle. Your right hand will go to the outside of your left thigh. Press the hand into the thigh into the hand. That'll help with balance. And now your left hand goes to the sacrum, and we gently twist to your left. Gently just feel that upper back, Perfect. Breathe. Wonderful. On your next breath in, come back to center. Take your time, take the hands down, and then we bring that left knee back. Maybe rock a few times. And from here, we're going to extend that left leg straight out. So we've got the hip, the knee, and the foot all in one line. And you're welcome to stay up on the hands or come down onto your forearms, as long as you feel nice and strong here. And that nice stretch through that left inner thigh. Wonderful. Keep breathing. Good. Slowly pressing your hands. So we come up. And now this is the one where we just lift the foot and lower the foot. So we lift the toes to the sky and left toes down. So do this about 5 more times. Go slow, feeling the back of the leg. If you need to bend your knee more, if that feels better for your leg, that's great. Keep breathing. We got a few more. Wonderful. And now that knee comes back and we'll take another child's pose here, this time changing the arms. The palms come together. Option one is palms together, head down. Option two is to bring your elbows forward, head down, and maybe bend your elbows so the thumbs come behind your neck. And if that's too much, keep your arms forward or separated. Release your hands, and now we're moving on to our belly. So your hips come down. I think everyone here is pretty far out from surgery, but if you ever feel that tightness in your lower belly, in that scar area, you can always walk your hands forward more so you come lower, okay? Today I'm going to be here with the elbow directly under the shoulder. Good. And just let your hips settle down here. And breathe. This is our back bend. We're opening the front body, we're opening the chest, and we're stretching that belly area nice and gradually. So just breathe. Perfect. On your next breath out, bring your elbows wide. And depending on how your chest is feeling, it could feel swelling or discomfort. If you don't want to put the pressure on the chest directly, do a fist over fist and rest your forehead. Or if you're okay with that, you can come down, rest your forehead. And we'll be here just a few deep breaths. Now keeping your head down, bend the knees and just windshield wiper legs. We rock the legs side to side. I'm making some circles here. Relax your legs. Slowly take your wrists under your shoulders, push up onto your knees, and then through all fours. Great. So let's find our strap so that we have it for the next series of poses that we're going to do. If you want to sit on blanket, you can. If you don't, that's fine. It's just going to give us a little bit of a lift in your hips. But it's not necessary. And we'll start with our legs directly out in front of us. Perfect. Now if you take your towel strap and put it around the bottoms of the feet, we'll roll the hands just a few times so that your arms are nice and long and you feel comfortable with your hands. Good. Now lean back just a little bit. There you go. So let your trust yourself, let your chest stretch, your arms stretch. I see someone in the waiting room, so I'm gonna let them in. Keeping that strap on the bottoms of the feet. And bending those elbows, bring your chest forward. Good. Bend the knees a little bit here and breathe. Perfect. Now slowly sit up tall. And we'll let go of that strap for a moment, pointing and flexing the feet. So we point and flex. There you go. Point and flex. Welcome in, welcome in. You're welcome to join in. And now roll your feet one way and the other. And I always say the same thing. If you're on any of the estrogen blocking drugs or any of those AIs, those joints get stiff. So I like to roll my feet out every day, spread the toes, keep those ankles nice and mobile. Wonderful. So we'll find our right leg and we're bending that knee so that your right knee is out to the side and your left leg is extended. Perfect. And you have your strap close by. We're going to take this strap on the bottom of your left foot. Gently press the right thigh towards the ground, and it's okay if it's up here. Just gently guide it towards the ground. Doesn't have to touch. And then we'll do that same thing where we roll the strap in the hands a few times, lift the chest and breathe in, and now hinge forward until you start to feel the hip, the hamstring, whatever it is going on in that lower body. And then once you get to your point where you feel like you want to hold and breathe, let's stay there and breathe. Perfect. Good. Slowly come up. Release your strap for now. And now we're going to keep this bent knee, but lift it up to the sky. Now holding onto your right leg with your left hand. That will free your right hand. Breathe in, bring it up. And slowly twisting to your right. There you go. And just feel that nice upper back twist. Breathe here. So it feels good in your spine, shoulders relax. And then as we breathe in, we're gonna come back the way we came in, reach that right arm up and down. Very good. Now just shaking out those legs. We'll do that same series on the opposite side. Now bending the left knee. Gently kind of rock, maybe push the thigh towards the ground. We never want to push on the knee itself. And then we can find that strap, put it on the bottom of your extended foot. Roll it a few times, breathe in. And then gently come forward. Good. Relax your shoulders here. Feel that nice opening, nice stretch there. Oh, on your next inhale, gently come up. You can release the strap. And now this left leg, we're just lifting the knee to the sky. Right hand goes around that left shin. Inhale, left arm up. And exhale, twist to your left. Stay nice and tall, relaxing your shoulders. Just take your head wherever your neck feels comfortable. And breathing in, bring that left arm up and around and down. And now shaking out those legs for a moment. I'm just going to turn my body so that you all can see me, but you can stay where you are. And taking the legs to a comfortable, however you're comfortable, cross-legged. We're going to do a little more with the upper body now. Good. And we'll start by just keeping that neck nice and loose. So ear to the shoulder, breathe in. And exhale, chin comes down. Inhale on the other side. Exhale, chin comes down. One more on each side. Find our strap and take your strap behind your back. Your palms are going to face away from you and the strap goes right between your hands. Can you all see that? You're a little more than shoulder distance apart. And start just by pressing your knuckles down and lifting your chest. See how that feels. It's going to feel different on everyone, okay? And you can stay here or you can gently lift and lower a few times, kind of like an upper back massage. No pain, no discomfort, just that nice stretchy sensation. You're going to maybe feel one side more than the other. These nice little sensations that pop up. Sometimes they come out of nowhere. Good, and now find a space where you feel like you can breathe and gently pull that strap apart. Chin is away from the chest and just relax here and breathe. And then gently release the arms, move the strap to the side. Good. If you're sitting cross-legged, noticing which foot is in front. And sit back a little and switch feet. So we just have our legs in a non-habitual way. Now find one hand and walk it away from you. Your shoulders are relaxed away from your ear. The opposite arm, we're going to start with that little chicken wing that we made earlier and just roll it, right? And you can look down, you can look forward, you can look the other way. Just see what feels best. So this is option one, is to keep the hand on the shoulder and draw the elbow back. Next option is to bend your elbow and take your head back into your hand as if your hand were a pillow. And that's going to give us a deeper stretch down through the triceps and the side body. And this extended arm, shoulders down away from your ear. Just enjoy this nice side stretch. Good. And breathing, the most important part is the breath. Come to center. Exhale, release. Just shake out those hands. Feel the difference on the right side and the left side. And then we'll go the other way. Go slow. Take your time. Walk the hand away from you. Shoulder away from ear. Start with that nice little chicken wing and just roll it out. Option one, you can keep the fingers there if you like that. Again, take your neck wherever you're comfortable. If you want to, you can take the hand behind your head and press your head back. And of course, you know, the side, if you had any lymph nodes out, that side's going to feel tighter for a while. I still feel a lot of tightness there, but it feels good, like a good stretch, like, okay, my body needs this. And that's where you should be with that stretch. Feels like, oh, this is good. I need more of this. We want that sensation when we're doing the yoga. Good. And now inhale, come through center. Release that. Perfect. We'll stretch our fingers now. And I don't know if we've done that in a while. So let's stretch those fingers. Just open up your palm and take the palm away from you. Opposite hand, we reach down and grab where the thumb meets the hand and gently pull it towards you. Keep the shoulders relaxed, head relaxed. And go down each finger for one or two breaths. Get this nice stretch there. If you do any typing or texting, I know we all do, so it's always good to stretch the hands for everyone. Go all the way to the pinky. And once you're all the way done with one hand, just feel the difference in the right hand and the left hand. And then take the other side. Take your time, palm up and pull down gently. Good. Breathe here. Time if you're still working on it. I'll meet by rolling those wrists around one way and the other. Wonderful. So we're going to move onto our backs. You'll need your blanket and your strap. So I like to put them about halfway down the mat just so you don't have to get up again. And now I'm turning around so y'all can see, but I'm scooting forward and then rolling onto the back. Good. Once you get onto your back, draw those knees into the chest and just roll your knees one way, making some circles. Massage your back and then go the other way. Good. And we're moving into a gentle figure four. Left leg comes down, right leg goes on top. Let your left foot stay on the ground for a moment and just rock the legs side to side. So as we do this, we really keep the shoulders down and we feel that stretch all down the side of the body, maybe into the hips, maybe into the glute. Just depends on what's needing it more. We go side to side. Perfect. And now we're just going to switch sides. So figure four, the left leg over the right. And start rocking those legs again. Good. Wonderful. From here, both feet are down. And we're going to do this one because we're a little farther out from surgery. So I'm going to demonstrate and you can join in. If I lift one arm up, I just want you to lift the arm that's closest to the screen so you can see. That arm becomes a pillow and I'm rolling onto that side, right? So I'm rolling onto the side, knees are bent for comfort. Perfect. And now the knees are bent so I don't feel like I'm gonna fall over, feel nice and stable. Lifting that top arm, let's start by rolling that wrist one way and the other. Good. Now I'm making some circles in the air. You're feeling that shoulder start to open. Head is down, head is relaxed. Maybe going the other way. The circle can be bigger or smaller. It's up to you. How's it feel? Now let that arm just hang back a little bit. Let your hand relax. Keeping that chest stretch. Good. Bring your hand down, and then we're going to take our hand right around that top ankle. Okay, and if that's not possible, you can always use your strap around the ankle, and it's going to let you find that grip, okay? But if you can grab your ankle, we can go for it. Knee comes down and gently push your hips forward, and this is where it's going to take some time if you're fresh or out of surgery. It's a little tighter in that area, that scar area, but if you're maybe 6 months or more out, you can start to feel that stretch in the quadricep and that hip flexor and that scar area. We'll take another breath in and gently, gently flex your foot so it's strong as you release down. Good job. Let's switch sides. So if you're comfortable, you can just roll to the other side. So you're on the opposite side. I'm gonna swivel just in case anyone needs to see me. And we use the arm as a pillow and start by lifting the top arm and rolling the wrist. Feel that nice mobility in the wrist. And then we can move that into the shoulder. So we make some circles one way and the other. Let your arm just hang back. Let your hand relax. We're breathing. Perfect. Bring your hand down. And now take your time either with the strap or your hand around the ankle. Bringing that knee down. Feel that stretch in the front of your body and breathe. And then gently flex the foot to release. Good job. And we'll roll back onto our backs. And just rock the knees side to side. And while we do that, we'll find our strap or towel. And that goes on the bottom of your right foot. Now, depending on how tight you are in the scar area, some people will start by bending the knee, the left leg, or some people want the leg straight. So I'll meet you halfway, so there's a small bend in the knee, but if you're comfortable, you can take the opposite leg down to the ground. And we're just starting with some circles again, so really massaging through that hip. And this should feel nice and soothing in the low back. After the surgery, the low back gets tight. I mean, for a long time. For me, it was over a year. I always felt this slight discomfort. And it's gotten so much better over time with stretching and just strengthening. Good. And you can go the other way. Wonderful. And from here, we're going to take the right leg a few inches to the left. Not all the way down, right? But just a few inches to the left. So we feel the outside of the leg stretching, the outer hip and the outside of the thigh. Wonderful. Breathe here. Now gently bend the knee just enough so you can safely come back to center. And we'll take that right leg out to the right, just keeping the hips down, feeling that nice inner thigh stretch. And now breathe and come back up. Bend both knees and do a little foot switch. So now the left foot is in the strap, right foot is down or leg straight, either or. And we start with the left leg, making small circles here. Think low back massage, hip massage. Maybe go the other way. Now that left leg goes just a few inches to the right. So we feel that outer leg stretch here. Wonderful. And just breathe. Head is relaxed. Shoulders are relaxed. Center, take your left leg out to the left, feel that inner thigh stretching. Great, now coming back to center and bend the knee. We're done with the strap today. You can just set it down to the side and draw your knees into your chest and making a few circles one way and a few circles the other way. Soles of the feet come down. We'll do just a little back strengthening, some pelvic tilts, which are always nice to throw in. So remember, we have that $1,000 bill underneath the low back, and we're going to tuck the pelvis under so the back is flat against your mat, and then relax. So maybe there's a little bit of an arch. Exhale, press down. So it's hard to see, but when we do it, we feel quite a bit, and relax. So we'll do several more. You don't have to count. Just breathe and move, pressing that low back down, activating and relaxing. And keep going. Activate, push down. Release. Do a few more. Take your feet a little wider, knees close, and we'll do a little more for the upper body. Option one, you can goalpost your arms like we did earlier in the lunge, remember in the beginning, but we're on the back now, so maybe your hands touch. If that's too much, just bring your arms lower and hands out. So we're all gonna feel that stretch in the chest area. And that's one place to start. And then if you'd like to, turn your head in one direction so that ear is close to the ground and you'll feel that stretch in the opposite shoulder. Just breathe there. Inhale to the center and take your head the opposite way and just breathe. Your arms down. Very good. Soles of the feet down. We'll do a little bit of a back bend to open that front body, and we'll tuck our shoulders under and press the hands down. Or if you have a yoga mat, I like to hold the edges of the mat. And then when we lift the hips and the chest and the belly, we'll look straight up at the ceiling. So you can watch first, but when we do it, please look straight up to protect your neck. Tucking the shoulders under, lifting the hips and the belly, breathing. Just opening the chest, stretching the front of the body as we strengthen the back of the body. slowly tuck your pelvis under like we did earlier, and then come down, 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 tailbone down at the end, and release. Wonderful. Rock those knees side to side. And then we'll grab the back of your right thigh. Left knee stays bent or left leg straight. And I'll take a few circles here. Switch sides, opposite leg, left knee in, right foot down, and make a few circles. Blanket or a pillow, it's just nice for that extra cushioning. You can put that right between your thighs and lift your hips a little to the right and set them back down. And that way, when we bring the knees to the left, we have that nice twist. It's like when we sleep with the pillow between the thighs, right? And keeping the shoulders down, maybe look the opposite way if you're comfortable. Deep breathing. Take your time, draw the knees to center. Give yourself a moment, reset your hips before we switch sides, and then maybe lift your hips to the left. The knees can come up and to the right. Shoulders stay down, and maybe we look over opposite shoulder and just breathe. Bring the knees to center. Reset your hips. Draw the knees into the chest. Give yourself a hug. And then let your feet come down one by one. And we'll come into our relaxation and our deep breathing now. If you want to put a little something under your head, that's always nice. If you want to put a blanket under your knees and stretch your legs out, that's also nice. And if you're not comfortable with your legs extended yet, then just bend your knees and take your knees together. Once you find that place, that space where you feel comfortable and you can relax, take a deep breath deep into your belly. And now exhale the air out. And breathe deep into your belly. And let your belly fill up with air. And exhale the air out. Do that one more time, the deepest breath in. And the longest breath out. Just let your body be heavy here and relax. You're very relaxed and you're in your own space. You're welcome to stay here as long as you'd like. Please let yourself stay relaxed as possible. And if you're ready to move on with your evening, just deepen your breath. And then wiggle your fingers and your toes. Draw your knees towards your chest and just rolling onto your comfortable side. Curl up for a moment. From here, you can keep your eyes closed and slowly just find a comfortable seat. If you're sitting and breathe in deeply and out. We'll take our hands onto our heart and think of something that you're grateful for, anything at all. To heart center and thanking ourselves for making the time to take care of our minds, our bodies. Namaste, everyone.